morning, ladies and gentlemen. We're jumping right in today. This morning. It's early morning. I woke up around 1:30, got some work done, figured I'd jump in and finish some stuff, and let's continue the story. Second part of the campaign. I played the first 6 missions yesterday. So today we're moving on to mission 7. Oh, I forgot to talk to those two guys. Let's go back out real quick. Can I get out? I guess I can't get out of the briefing room once I'm in here.
First, congratulations. Because you captured the Star Destroyer Victorum, our Starhawk prototype has been completed ahead of schedule. But the Empire does not know that. They believe it's still under construction. Darissa Carroll will keep hunting Project Starhawk until it's destroyed. And we've been assigned to stop her. So, using that decoy message I sent, we're going to set up an ambush. The false intel stated that you're protecting a shipment of magnite crystals, essential to completing the Starhawk. With this bait, we'll draw Tarissa and the Overseer deep into the Xavian Abyss, a highly volatile area of space. Here is where we set our trap. Don't worry about the convoy. It's empty and droid piloted. However, that does mean you'll need to clear any obstructions from its path. Vanguard, I want you to defend that convoy with everything you've got. We need to make this look good.
Okay.
Our destination is this bottleneck. There, the Starhawk will be waiting to disable the Overseer, and hopefully, capture Tarissa. Now, it might sound simple, but nothing is simple in the Xavian Abyss. Brace yourselves.
If Lyndon's right, this plan could knock Tarissa Carroll off our tail. Sooner the better, if you ask me.
Sure.
Lyndon's convinced himself that he's put us in danger. I can't make him focus on the bigger picture while Tarissa's still in it. The commander's a smart man, but everyone has someone who can push their buttons. I wonder if we can push hers, too. We'll give Tarissa a harmless convoy to follow. Play this out and see just how far we can lead her. It's all about playing the long game. When the Empire occupied Mon Cala, I learned how to string Imperials along. If you seem harmless, people underestimate you. I spent a lot of time around Imperials, playing the dumb alien, a bartender, a sweeper, someone safe. Next day, the Rebellion would know everything I'd overheard. Wasn't easy, but I learned to stay patient and wait for opportunities. Remember, the Xavian Abyss is no place for the faint-hearted. And Tarissa knows a few tricks of her own. Keep your eyes and ears open, all right?
Well, always do.
And the Starhawk's crew.
More than ready. I selected the crew personally based on their expertise and experience. They've been training for months.
That's good. I appreciate your support on this, General.
It's a good plan, Lyndon. Just be careful. I know you have a past with the Overseer's captain. Don't let it cloud your judgment.
One moment, General. Sorry. I can't talk right now. Your squadron is waiting.
Secrets within secrets. Yeah, I guess I missed that dialogue option because I went in there before I talked.
I've heard tales of the Xavian Abyss. They say it's swallowed entire fleets without a trace. Sending our brand new Starhawk in there is quite the gamble. Commander Javes must have complete faith in its builders. And in us, of course. We'll be the ones making this ruse work, after all. I took the liberty of studying the Starhawk's blueprints. It's not just another capital ship. It's a defense against Imperial fleets. Every spare inch is packed with lasers and munitions, but what really caught my eye was the tractor beam. If I understood the blueprints, the Starhawk's tractor beam is 10 times more powerful than that of a Star Destroyer. It's incredible. The magnite crystals they use in the Starhawk's tractor beam are quite rare. I think they salvaged a few from the Star Destroyer we captured. My family spent an exorbitant amount of credit sourcing magnite crystals. It's so gratifying to see them go to a good cause. Let's put our new Starhawk through its paces, shall we?
It also looks a lot like the ship from Star Wars The Old Republic, from the Knights of the Old Republic. Knights of the Fallen Empire, excuse me, that expansion.
So, the boss wants to pull the old bait and switch on Teresa. I must be rubbing off on him. Of course, the key to a good con is selling it. And going into the Xavian Abyss, well, either you're too naive to know better, or you think it's worth the risk. Like, say, stopping a Starhawk from being finished. Teresa Carroll's risking the Abyss just for the chance to destroy some magnite crystals. Ain't she in for a surprise? I'm kind of excited to see our Starhawk tackle Teresa's flagship. All those engineers worked their tails off to get it finished. That's one good thing about this new Republic. We're finally punching at the same weight as the Empire. One way or another, this is gonna be a show.
I gotta fly a Y-Wing again. Boo. Oh no, I get to choose.
For this mission, an X-Wing, Y-Wing, or A-Wing?
Oh, I'm choosing X-Wing, baby.
Check the schematics and let me know. You got it.
Of course I'm taking X-Wing.
If you need it, I got it.
Only way to roll.
Once the Starhawk disables the Overseer. The same as the Victorum, I expect. Board it, lock its systems, and take the crew prisoner.
I don't know, Grace. I can't imagine Teresa Carroll coming along quietly. I hate these clouds. Who knows what's out there?
We know what's out there. A Star Destroyer with a captain who wants us dead.
Real helpful. Thanks, Cunny. The convoy's droid autopilot ain't smart enough to steer through these asteroids.
Then let's blast them a path.
Wait, look. A Star Destroyer. What's left of one?
I'd say it's been here a long while.
You'd think this would discourage Teresa Carroll.
To someone like her, that wreckage ain't a warning. It's one more insult.
It's one of the destroyers from the Clone Wars.
Imperial ships are on radar.
communications. Give them a show. Make sure they buy it.
Working on it.
Signal's breaking up. Let's push on.
The ambush point is this way. Ready? Let's go.
Oh yeah, look at that. That's what you think.
Fighters. More Imperial fighters. Check behind. Focus on the bombers.
One more for me. Cut shot.
I'm with you.
Oh, crap. crap. Yet.
Vanguard, the Overseer is targeting you. I need more time. Destroy Teresa while we charge the tractor beam. And stay alive. Fine, you're on course. Watch the storm. Taking out her fighters one by one should be very distracting. Captain Carroll to Vanguard Squadron. This is a futile gesture. You have nowhere to go, and I have no interest in prisoners. You see that shot?
Oh, there's an asteroid. I'm in the storm and I have no idea where the mission's actually at. Oh, I guess the arrow is showing me. That looks exactly like the ship from Knights of the Fallen Empire.
Titan,
made it out.
Well, we know the Starhawk works. Toss the Overseer around like a low threat.
Good.
Lousy Imperials deserve payback with interest.
Shall we just build a Death Star and get it over with?
Oh, come on, Grace. We're still the good guys. Anyhow, we won, right? Wherever they jumped, no ship's coming back from that.
We don't know that.
Let's hope so.
I got all the medals that time.
Where are we?
House of Rem. Remetic system. Grid L42.
Scramble fire crews. Get a distress call to the nearest Imperial station.
There's an old munitions depot in this system, Captain. Run by a Colonel Grom. Must be our lucky day.
Make the call. This isn't over, thank God.
So, you jump to my territory, uninvited, then demand my supplies?
Colonel Grom. The Starhawk project is within our grasp. All I need is repairs and proper munitions.
No. The Emperor assigned me to this depot. I decide how its resources are used. As of this moment, that includes your Star Destroyer. Consider yourself reassigned.
The Overseer was sent on this mission by Admiral Sloan herself.
Admiral Sloan isn't here, Captain. I have rebel guerrillas to deal with. And now, so do you. Grom out.
He wants us to fight rebels. All right. We'll protect his depot. And if his munitions get lost in the crossfire, well, lucky for us.
Ma'am, regulations specifically forbid this.
I will not be beaten by Vanguard, grandstanding imbeciles, or anyone else.
Please, your judgment.
It's just fine. Call in Titan Squadron. Now. Could we talk?
Yes, we can, but I need a juice.
That could have gone better.
I never expected that cobbled-together battleship to be more dangerous than the Xavian Abyss. Those dockyard coordinates almost cost us the Overseer. Look at this place. The deck below is even worse. And did you hear? We're not being given the munitions we need to strike back. No wonder Captain Carroll's furious. We'll get through this. Think of Battlegroup Echelon after the skirmish at Marisi. Supply lines cut, their admiral's flagship captured. But they rallied. They fended off the enemy, made repairs in hostile territory, and launched a daring rescue. And when they were ready, they returned to crush the rebels under heel. There's always a way to win. The captain summoned us. Let's not test her patience.
Local rebel forces are preparing to attack Colonel Graham's munitions depot. You'll patrol the area in preparation for the attack, and keep the depot safe. Graham is a fool, but his assets belong to the Empire. Therefore, they belong to us. During your patrol, Titan III will secretly search the station, its freighters, and cargo shuttles for Baradium. This explosive material will be a valuable tool against the Starhawk. Tag the Baradium, and LT-514 will retrieve it remotely. While Graham is kept busy by the rebel attack, escort the Baradium to the Overseer for safekeeping. According to the Colonel, these three towers hold large munition stockpiles and will be the rebels' priority targets. It's a powder keg. If we lose the towers, we lose the depot, and the Overseer will be defenseless. Remember, as long as repairs are still underway, we can't afford to engage the Republic. Secure the Baradium, halt the Rebel assault, and then we can leave the Remetic system. You're on your own, Titan Squadron. Let's do this right. Why is it that small-minded officers are always the quickest to flaunt what little power they have? Graham can lord over this pathetic corner of the galaxy all he likes, but I will not allow him to jeopardize our mission. This depot has everything we need to annihilate the Starhawk. Graham may be an obstacle, but he's not our enemy. We will do our duty to protect Imperial assets. Go. Prepare your ship.
Yeah, to our duty, but maybe a little five-finger discount won't hurt along the way.
I owe you and the rest of Titan Squadron an apology. When the Overseer was attacked, I realized that everything I know about war is what I've read. I'm beginning to understand how it must feel in that cockpit under fire. Terrifying. Yet you and the others risk it every day. I took this assignment to learn. Clearly, I still have a long way to go. I know Colonel Graham is in the wrong, and yet seizing his munitions feels drastic. But Captain Carroll is entirely correct that Admiral Sloan's orders supersede Graham's, and we are committed.
Yes, this is true.
To work. There's much to do.
Sometimes you gotta do things that you don't necessarily agree with. That's just life.
Routine is familiar. We've suffered. We're damaged. Broken, even. But it's not the end. Never is. Next steps are simple. We heal up, find Vanguard, then take revenge.
Sounds simple.
The first crash was hardest. Had to relearn breathing, walking. Saw my cockpit in nightmares. Wasn't personal. The rebels shot me down. My wingmate returned fire. But pain is personal. My team deserved my best, The Empire demanded it. So, step by step, I conquered pain. I rose. I flew. Nadiri's ahead. Until then, surviving is revenge. Let's fix this.
Combat launch is imminent. Repeat, launch imminent.
It never fails. Bureaucratic bastards like Colonel Graham are always in the way. My brothers died on a rebel raid with the 181st that never should have happened. I blame the Imperial Senator, who pushed for that doomed mission just as much as I blame the rebels who fired the torpedoes. Pick any military disaster, and you'll always find some bantha-brained bureaucrat was behind it. Captain Carroll is making the right call with this mission. Let's go.
Let's do this. Ah. Ooh, I get to fly an interceptor.
Captain Carroll has assigned you a TIE interceptor. This machine is built to cut down enemy fighters. And that's what you do best.
It is what I do best. Might be getting sleepy, finally.
Final tower is clear. No sign of the rebels yet.
Graham has several ships in the area. Target and scan them to locate the Peridium.
Titan 3, split up and find it. Scanning freighter. Titan 3, do the same.
Thank you.
That's it. The radio. I'm tracing its signature across the depot now.
Titan Squadron, regroup.
Forming up on your position.
Excellent. We'll secure the Viridium during the enemy raid.
We're ready for them.
Titan, we have rebel forces emerging from hyperspace.
Right on time.
Rebel bombers are targeting the control towers. Kill those bombers, Titan.
Destroy the towers, we lose the depot.
Then the Overseer will be overrun. Or worse. They're going for Tower One.
Those are mines, so I can't self-repair on this ship.
Titan, it's time. Escort the cargo shuttle to the Overseer. Graal won't notice a thing while he's under siege. I'm here. Let's go.
Focus on the Baradium. We'll take care of one shuttle crew.
Titan 3 and I will handle the other.
They're on the other side of the ship.
Another's gone.
Cargo shuttles are en route but vulnerable. Move to assist.
I'm here. Let's go.
And those little bastards are fast.
Thank you. Target down.
We're with you. The Baradium is ours, and Graal is none the wiser.
You hope.
We have everything we need to annihilate the rebel base, their Starhawk, and Lyndon Javes. Enemies incoming.
They've sent in a frigate. Destroy it immediately. Shields are down.
Yeah, and almost me along
with
her.
Both Grom's mission and ours, Captain. Titan, dock aboard. aboard the depot for immediate debriefing.
Titan Squadron, return to the Overseer at once. We're leaving the Remetic system.
Captain, I reassigned you.
My orders come from above you, Colonel Growl. I have everything I came for. Cut communications with this imbecile.
You'll regret this, Captain. I promise you that.
Amos, Grom, we keep running into fools who forget what side they're on. See, this is why we need a new Imperial Senate. Someone who can keep these idiots in check.
We have a war to win. Officers like Grom need direction, not a leash. Looking to the horizon is all very well, Sol, but remember to look at what's going on around you.
With that Baradium at our disposal, we'll be at the forefront of the attack on the Nadiri dockyards.
We got caught off guard at the Xavian Abyss. That can't happen again.
In one move, Captain Carol took us from a near shipwreck to a key military asset. She'll have a plan.
Let's see what's next.
Our victory is nearly at hand. We have the location of the Nadiri dockyards, and the Overseer is almost back to full strength. Our only obstacle now is Vanguard Squadron. I won't let them catch us off guard. Not again. Admiral Sloane has a plan to draw Vanguard Squadron and other defenders away from the Nadiri dockyards. The Admiral has ordered Titan Squadron to play a part, and she wants you to take the lead. For this mission, at least. I trust Admiral Sloane's decision. You've proven yourself capable many times over. Just don't let it go to your head. It would be a pity if you turned out like Colonel Grom.
All right, well, I think we're going to wrap it up here. Shorter stream for the moment, because I'm getting tired. Like, I'm gonna go back to bed, and I'll be back later on today with part 3 of the campaign. Till then.